God has been good. He's been better to me than what I've been to myself, and I know that to be the truth. Let us go into a word of prayer. Father, we thank you for this time, this opportunity once afforded to us to come to worship with one another, O Lord, come to fellowship with one another, and just to lift up a word, O Heavenly Father, from your holy book, the Bible. We thank you, O Heavenly Father, that we know that the blood will never lose its power. Regardless as to what we might be faced with, the blood will never lose its power. We thank you, O Lord, for this time, this opportunity, once again afforded to us, that we might speak unto thy people. And I ask once again, O Lord, if you please, just hide this, your servant, behind the cross, that those who are here might see thee and not me. Well, Lord, we thank you, O Heavenly Father. Now let the words of my mouth, the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, my strength, my redeemer. In the name of Christ our Lord, we ask it all. Amen. Amen. It's good to be here once again. This is the day that we honor the seniors of the church, all of our senior members who are sitting right here and across the aisles from you today. We honor our seniors on this day. We are grateful to God for what you all have done to pave the way for what we have done. Brother Dunn's going to correct me on that. What we have done to pave the way for the younger generation. Yeah, I got to admit, I'm a senior now. Thank you, Jesus. You know, it's better than the alternative. When you can live to get a few years behind you, God has truly been good. So you got to acknowledge the goodness of God. And to those of you who are still thinking you're young, remember the Bible says 80 years, and if by reason of strength 80, yet there's strength, labor, and sorrow, for it's soon cut off and we fly away. So at 35 and max of 40, you're in middle age. So that's a revelation to some of you who are sitting there today thinking, well, I'm still in the young crowd. Now you're in middle age now. So thank God for your middle age. Amen. Amen. Thank God for it. Praise him for your middle age. Amen. I'm glad that our seniors made it on their trip and made it back safely. Thank God that you were able to go to D.C. And we're going to have a talk. Seniors, all right? Amen. We're going to have a talk. We worry and stay on our knees for y'all when y'all take that long of a trip. So we're going to have a talk, okay? Amen. For those of you who have your Bibles with you on this morning, I invite you to the book of Joshua in the Old Testament. The book of Joshua. For all of you who were here, we had a great week of revival. Amen. We had such a, Pastor John Faison did such a beautiful job, and we enjoyed him so very much. He blessed our hearts in this week of revival. I was so sorry that we could only have 2 days, but we had a glorious time those 2 days of revival. We truly did. The first chapter of the book of Joshua, it reads as such, beginning at verse 1. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' assistant, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, you and all these people, to the land which I am giving to them, the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given you, as I've said to Moses, from the wilderness of this Lebanon as far as the great river, the river Euphrates, all the lands of the Hittites, and to the great sea toward the going down of the sun shall be your territory. No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and of good courage, for to this people you shall divide the inheritance, the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. Only be strong and very courageous, that you may observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right hand or the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. The book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that I have written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. I just want to lift up from this, he's with you. He's with you. On last week, we went through the part as to where faith can, or fear rather, can overcome your faith if you're not careful. We saw where the first available opportunity that the children of Israel actually had of entering the promised land, and what God's promises to them had been, that they failed, being that the report that came back was the fact that they had entered the land, and yes, the produce was plentiful. It was a land that flowed with milk and honey. It was a land as to where there's so much to be gained over there. But because of the people who lived in that land, because of their height, their stature, their muscular build, that the children of Israel looked back and they said, we are like grasshoppers in their sight. But when God promises something, God will not go back on his promise. He has said, I will be with you. He had promised this once before when the children of Israel spied out the land. 10 came back and said, we don't need to do that. 2 came back and said, let's go. And from the report, the negative report that was given from the previous occasion, 40 now years ago, the report that was given was so negative that they feared and they did not enter into the land and take it as the Lord had so promised. He had promised on that previous occasion, I will be with you. I will not forsake you. I am even going to do something miraculous for you. If you remember the promise on last week, there are battles that you're not even going to have to fight. I'm going to send hornets in to drive the people out before you. But they did not accept, they did not believe, they did not trust God for the journey at that time. And now 40 years have passed. The generation that was 20 years and older have died out. And now these who were at the age of 19 and approaching almost to get to 20 are now the inheritors of the land. He promised it to the children of Israel. He promised it to the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He promised them that they would live in this land, but yet it has taken now 40 years. 40 years God has provided for them. 40 years God has fed them in a wilderness area. 40 years he has given them water to drink. 40 years he has allowed their cattle to reproduce and live in a barren land. 40 years he has allowed them to survive what seems to be insurmountable odds 40 years they have survived, and now Moses has died. Moses has gone up to the mountain. The last time they see him, he is leaving them, and God officiates the eulogy as well as the burial of Moses. And the Bible says no man knows where his tomb is to this day. God has buried Moses somewhere on the mountain. And now God speaks to Joshua and he tells him, arise, take these people over to that land of promise. Take them into that land that's going to flow with milk and honey. Take them in and let them possess the land. Let them take over what I promised them 40 years ago. And now he makes even another promise, and you see it as to how he encourages Joshua, and he tells them, have I not commanded you? Be strong of good courage. Do not be afraid nor dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Let's start right back there. Have I not commanded you? First of all, strength. Your strength is in the Lord. Our strength is in what God's word says. Our strength is in the promises that he makes to each one of us. That's how people, the seniors of the church have lived to get to the age that they have. God promised a long time ago, if you walk upright before me, no good thing will I withhold from you. It's not to say they've been perfect people all of their lives, but they have strived to walk upright before God. They've strived to live a life that would emulate what a Christian life is all about. They've strived to tell someone else the story about Christ being our Lord and Savior. They have been strong. They have been courageous. Look at what it says next. It tells them at that time, be strong, be of good courage, courageous in their pursuit, courageous in the understanding to rightly divide God's word of truth, courageous in living the life before their children and the children's children, that they might see Christ in them. Be strong, be courageous, stand for all the time, stand for what is right, forsake that which is wrong. Stand on the promises of God. God has promised some things, and God will not go back on his promises. God has promised us that he would be with us. God has promised us that he would take care of us. That's the reason why so many saints of old have a testimony as to how God brought them through the rough times, how he brought them through the lean times, and how he provided for them when they didn't have sense enough to provide for themselves. And there are many of us who haven't, and we did just tell the truth about it, we haven't had sense enough to provide for ourselves. But somehow, some way, God stepped in and made a way out of no way. Some of your children, they have never done without whatsoever. And young people, I'm speaking to you now because I think it's imperative. Some of you are off on the college campuses now, and some of you are there all by yourselves. You young people now who are coming into adulthood, and you've got to realize there's some time that you're going to have to do without. There's some times you're not going to be able to call on mom and dad, but you've got to have a relationship with the Lord that they've tried to impart into you all of these years, to understand that God will take care of you through a rough time. You've got to get a handle on that and try to understand that God is capable of taking care of you when mama and daddy are not around. Have I not commanded you? He says, be strong. first of all. Secondly, be of good courage. Be courageous in what you do. Be courageous to stand up and witness of the goodness of God. Be courageous in telling someone else about the faith that you found in Christ. Be courageous in letting them know as to what God's word actually says. Be courageous in your testimony when you stand firm in the foundation of the truths of God's word. Be courageous. And then he says, don't be afraid. I like that because I have found that sometimes fear can overcome your faith if you're not careful. But he tells you, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Be courageous. Don't be afraid. Do not be afraid of what might be out there ahead of you. Do you realize that as they journeyed toward the promised land, as they journeyed into these areas that the Lord had promised them, there were times that miracle after miracle happened. The very first battle that they are about to fight after entering into the promised land is that of the city of Jericho. The Bible tells us that Jericho was a fortified city. Jericho had thick walls. Jericho had walls that were so wide as to where history tells us that three chariots could ride abreast on top of the wall that surrounded the city of Jericho. Jericho had strong gates, and Jericho had things that were going on in it as to where immorality had taken over. But God said, I'm going to give you that city. And I was surprised when I read it as a young person years ago, when I just began to be interested and understand God's word and where I gathered a knowledge of his word. I was surprised at the battle strategy that God laid out to Joshua on how to conquer the city. He didn't tell him, get no cannon. God told Joshua, here's what I want you to do. Each day, once a day, I want you to march around the city. I don't want the people to say nothing. Read it when you get home. I don't want them to murmur a word. I want the Ark of God, the Ark of the Covenant, to go out ahead of them, and I want them to march around the city, go back to the camp. What? Mm-hmm. That city is fortified. How are we going to break through these walls? He said, but you're going to do that each day for 6 days. He said, but on the seventh day, I want you to change the strategy. I want you to march around it 7 times. And on the seventh circuit around the city, after they hadn't said anything all this time, I want you to sound the trumpet. And when you sound the trumpet, the walls are going to fall down flat. And God is faithful concerning his word. Sometimes the impossibilities of life are made possible simply by believing what God says. You got to trust God. And as people have said, old folk have told me before, those who have gone on to be with the Lord, son, trust him for one thing, trust him for all. Don't give up on God. Trust him in spite of what you see. It may look like it ain't going to turn out the way that you want it to turn out, but somehow, some way, God's got a plan. And God's working this thing out for his good. He says, don't be dismayed. Don't get confused. That's what he's talking about. So many times in life, people get confused. They get confused as to who is in charge. They get confused when they see what's going on in our world today. They get confused when things are coming their way as to all the changes that are taking place in this day and time. And they're confused on what's going on in our society. But I tell you this morning, don't get confused. Don't get confused, young folk, and go along with status quo. Status quo is going against the word of God. Status quo is telling us to do some things that are not in the will of God. Status quo and the laws that are being passed in this day and time are in direct opposition as to what God's word has to say. I stand upon the fact that God's word is true. Let all men be liars, but let God's word be the truth. And that's what we stand on. So don't get confused, he says. Don't get dismayed. And then the promise. Finally this morning, the promise is, he said, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. God is with you. If God be for us, who can be against us? If God be for us, we'll stand in the midst of the storm. If God be for us, though the world shakes around us, we'll stand upon the promises of God. If God be for us, the mountains can be moved and cast into the depth of the sea. But I'm going to stand on my faith in God and go, no, he'll keep me in my time of trouble. If God be for us, who can be against us? Have you trusted God? Do you believe his word? Have you grounded yourself in the fact that God's word is true, and every promise that he has made, he will fulfill? I promise you, singers, keep on walking by faith. Keep on testifying of the goodness of God. Keep on telling the younger generation how that the Lord brought you through. Keep on keeping on. Keep on until the Lord says, well done, good and faithful servant. Just keep on inspiring. Keep on living the life that you've lived in the past. Keep on holding up the blood-stained banner of Jesus Christ, because one day I believe that God is coming back for his church. I believe he's going to send Jesus to split the clouds, and I believe in a place where the wicked shall cease from troubling and where the weary shall be at rest. I believe in a city that's built on 12 foundations. I believe that there is a place where there are three gates in the north, three gates in the south, three gates in the east, and three gates in the west. I believe that one day all of God's children are going to come into the city and bring the glory of God into the city. I believe in a place where one day we'll fall at his feet and cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. I believe that one day God will reward those who have walked by faith and not by sight and didn't give up in the middle of the battle. I'm going to fight on. I'm going to fight on to see what the end's going to be. As we say around here, going to be. I'm going to fight on to see what the end is going to be. Because I believe that God one day will reward those who've stood faithfully throughout the years to testify of his goodness. As the choir shall sing a verse of a song, the doors of the church are open to you. Come, come to Jesus. Letter, Christian experience, candidate for baptism. May we stand as the invitation is extended. If you're here and you're without a church home, our deacons are coming down to receive you into this church family. Step out by faith.